With shareholders coming to an agreement just last week, it seems that Disney will now own Fox, which means that the X-Men and Fantastic Four are coming home. We are all celebrating the homecoming of Marvel's first family and my favorite team of mutants joining the MCU, but it is truly concerning how so many overlook the dangers of a company like Disney having so much power, not to mention that jobs will be lost and certain guidelines will be set in place in the coming years, not just for their output of movies, but for cinemas and our wallets as well. I contemplated making a video detailing certain of these regulations, but seeing as it wouldn't be a lighthearted video for the most part, I decided against it. After all, this is something we all want. Perfectly balanced is all things should be. By now, if you've kept up with my videos, you know that I am a big fan of the X-Men and have been pretty vocal about my admiration for the films as well. Deadpool, Logan, Legion, and the first two X-Men films from both Singer and the first Clash trilogy are some of my favorite comic book films and shows ever. Ever since I saw Deadpool in theaters for the first time, I thought to myself that Ryan Reynolds is to Wade Wilson what Robert Downey Jr. is to Tony Stark. I always appreciated that even when the X-Men films were mediocre, they tried to do something different with each film, even amidst a loose timeline. But even looking at the timeline now, I feel this ultimately didn't matter as much when movies like Logan and Days of Future Past came out and were some of the best comic book films to come about. Fantastic Four has seemingly gone from painfully mediocre to absolute dumpster fire, and I can't quite figure out why. To the 05 and 07 films' credit, these aren't quite the worst films out there, but even then I always felt that they could have been a lot better. Whether it was Josh Trank or Fox's studio meddling, that doomed Fant Four stick, we'll never really truly know. But after the first 40 minutes of his film, it's a painful film to digest. The MCU's success hasn't been ignored, and with Black Panther and Infinity War both joining the billion-dollar ranks, it's not hard to see why Kevin Feige is eager to get his hands on the X-Men, because even when the X-Men films have been mediocre, they overall have all been modest to high successes. I feel the task of incorporating the X-Men into the MCU is much more challenging than we realize it is, even with the sexy Scarlet Witch already being present in the universe. X-Men isn't like Fantastic Four where they've had mostly forgettable movies that have been erased from people's memories, because the X-Men for the most part has had a solid trilogy. And when you have talented actors like Hugh Jackman, Michael Fassbender, Daphne Keene, Ian McKellen, Patrick Stewart, and quite a few others, calling the series forgettable or dissing its overall influence because of timeline or costume complaints really isn't a fair criticism. Echoing my thoughts from a video I did way back when regarding this same subject, if anything, Ryan Reynolds' Deadpool will be the easiest character to make the jump, and I sincerely hope they keep him as well. Ryan is just too good as the character, and it'd be a shame if his series didn't continue. After all, Deadpool and Spider-Man have met several times in the comics, and there was even a scenario titled Deadpool Kills the Marvel Universe. Disney's streaming service won't include R-rated content, not to anyone's surprise, so it's unlikely that we'll see that type of scenario. But with Bob Iger claiming that Deadpool will continue in R-rated fashion as long as we let the audiences know what's coming, I guess we'll have to wait and see. At any rate, I'm not saying that this can't be done, but it certainly will take time. Given Fox's plans prior to this deal with Gambit, X-23, Kitty Pryde, and Multiple Man all set to get spinoffs, I do feel it will be a while before the X-Men make the jump. Scarlet Witch may very well be the gateway for the mutants in the MCU, and I'd much prefer it, for example, if they kept Evan Peters' Quicksilver, but even so, this is one of the big questions. Not so much what changes will be made, but how many changes will be made. Fantastic Four have a higher advantage, and I have felt that, for a while, Marvel's first family certainly belongs in the MCU. Given Infinity War's success with Thanos, I can understand why the instant cries of Avengers 5 and Avengers 6 with Galactus, yeah, are something we frequently see. But I feel like the Fantastic Four, should they be given a trilogy, and if it is a trilogy that spans more than three films, then Galactus could serve as the big bad in the last installment of that trilogy. However, it certainly makes more sense for Galactus to be an Avengers level threat, and that alone excites me. In fact, the only thing that truly excites me about this deal is the Fantastic Four's inclusion in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Legion and Fargo creator Noah Hawley was set to create a Doom film for Fox, but it's unlikely that that will happen now. There was also a Silver Surfer film in active development, but I'm guessing that that film won't happen either. I'd personally love to see Noah's Doom film, given my enjoyment of Legion, But something tells me he wasn't making that film for it to connect to anything. Regardless of how I feel, this will inevitably expand the MCU and also bring more characters to the big screen as well. And I hope that with Cassie Lang being somewhat of a prominent character over in the world of Ant-Man, that maybe somewhere down the line, we get to see Franklin Richards in the MCU. The only question is, will we see these characters in the MCU before 2020? I think it's highly unlikely that any of the MCU films that release next year, Captain Marvel, Avengers 4, or Homecoming 2, with the exception of Captain Marvel, which is rumored to include the Skrulls, will include any other Fox characters, because the deal will not be official until sometime next year, also rumored to be before the summer of 2019. I'm guessing that most likely, once the deal gets approved, then Marvel will likely reveal a slate with some added release dates and some shifts as well, with Guardians of the Galaxy 3 likely being one that gets shifted. But that's another topic for another video. Despite me wanting to see Fox's X-Men series continue to grow, part of me is curious to see what Kevin Feige sets in motion for the Children of the Atom, because the guy is a comics fan like many of us, first and foremost, and he actually served as a producer for a few of the X-Men films. I can't say that he won't give us something special, but I hope we get more Days of Future Past's X2 and something we haven't seen from my favorite team of mutants, and that the Fantastic Four and X-Men's Homecoming isn't something we've seen already.